never getting off track. Episode 17. Yo. Whew. And we're live. Are we live? I hope so. Is it hotter than Satan's friggin' ballsack out here? Yes. Did I rearrange all my mom's furniture on the patio? Yes. Did I find good lighting? No. I tried inside. Nothing worked. The sun's coming in the window. I couldn't figure it out. Does it matter? Kinda. I wanted to make a cool location. Not happening. Anyway, I leave for the airport in 1 hour. I had to get this up. What's good? Dunk Life Daily, we got the mobile podcast, second episode of the mobile podcast. Who remembers the first one? Anyway, I'm bringing this freaking thing to Colombia. This is going to be a Dunk Life podcast from Colombia. It might be in Spanish, so get your Duolingo going. And yeah, cars in the background, I don't know if you can hear, but this is fun. Am I sweating already through my brand new Dunk Life shirt, which looks amazing? Yes. Am I going to go sweaty to the airport? Yes. Do I need to get the energy out of my system before I go to the plane? Yes. Will that help? No, because I'm going to have plenty. Anyway, going to dunk when I'm on vacation. If I can find a court, that would be amazing. But anyway, I have a vlog coming out. Number one thing, vlog coming out right after this. Please go watch it. I put a lot of time into it, and also I push myself really hard. I think it's valuable, and I really want that to help my channel. Those are the things that help my channel the most. And I also love this podcast, and I love my channel to show you myself trying to grow. That's kind of what today's episode is about, is my goals and detaching from goals. Because I saw a comment last episode, which was a great comment. They said something like, I hope you blow up, even though it's not one of your goals. And that's not a negative. That's a good thing. But it is one of my goals. I just don't talk about it that much. But this is what the idea of today I wanted to be was... When you have these goals, you detach from them, because it's not about always what the actual reality of the result is. For example, I want to be big on YouTube, but my main goal is the platform to be able to provide energy, to be able to inspire people, to help people dunk, all those different things. And that doesn't necessarily, there's a truck, that doesn't necessarily mean YouTube's going to be huge. 1 second. Woo, it's hot. I'm in 2 minutes in and I'm dying. And there's a giant truck. Please pass quicker. Okay. So what I was saying is that even though that's my goal to go get big on YouTube, the point of the goal is to... my mother thought it'd be funny to distract me. She did a great job of it, but then my camera died as well. So perfect timing. And it's hot as hell out here, but I'm trying to get this message out. Anyway, thanks, Mom. But yeah, what I was trying to say was that when you detach from them, your goals are big. You have these goals you want to do, but it doesn't matter how you get there. It's the essence of what the goal is. So I want my platform to be big, to reach people, to inspire them, whether it's through YouTube or not. But I get caught up sometimes in my YouTube getting big or my podcast getting big because that's what seems like the right path. But when you detach, you're open to the possibilities. Those are the two things. You're open to possibilities, which way you flow with your goals. So you got to be open and fluid. You don't want to be attached to one path, which I've talked about in the past, but you also don't want to be attached to results. Because it's more about what the result is, in the essence of it, in my opinion, and what I've learned and what I've read and all these different things, is that it's not always, like, for the YouTube's a perfect example. It doesn't mean that I'm going to have a giant YouTube to do what I want to do. It's about my goal is doing what I love to do and getting paid for it and enjoying every single day. So with YouTube is a great option to do that, but that's not the only option. So I have to be open to that. So that way I'm not attached to just one outcome. And that's it. I'm going to melt if I don't get inside. Please check out my vlog. If you're listening to this podcast, it's also on iTunes. Support your boy. It's on all the platforms. Subscribe. And on my YouTube, hit that little bell icon. It's super cool, dude. If you hit that bell, it's gonna it rings in your head when you wake up. It's not a notification on my channel, dude. It rings like freaking Notre Dame gargoyle style straight into your fucking dome right when you wake up. It's a new feature. I paid a lot for it. It's called the fucking ring my bell feature. It's called ring my fucking noggin. All right, I got to do it in today in history. I actually took a peek of this. On this day in history, July 27th, there was actually some cool ones. The coolest one of all, 1586, Walter Raleigh brings the first tobacco to England from Virginia. I'm just kidding. That's not the coolest one. But this one was weird. 1689, Battle of Killcranky. Jacobite Scottish Highlanders under Viscount Dundee defeat Royalist force under General Mackay. That's not the cool one. But that one, I read that one and I didn't even know what those words meant, if they were English. I think back then they weren't speaking in English. All right, these are the cool ones. Ready? 1940, Bugs Bunny, Warner Bros. Cartoon character created by Tex Avery and Bob Givens, Looney Tunes and Merry Melodies series, first debuts in wild hair. That sounds sick. Bugs Bunny, 1940. Today in music, 1982, Alan Menken of Howard Ashman's musical Little Shop of Horrors opens off Broadway at the Orpheum Theater in NYC. Now, the coolest one today in sports, 1999, Tony Hawk is the first skateboarder to land a 900. Spinning, bro. That boy was spinning. That's three. He just did three in a row. That's a 900. All right. And then last but not least, the dunk lifer of the day from the last podcast. One of the comments was, I hope you get really big. That was a really awesome one. And then the other comments, if it loads, I had a few good ones that I really liked. Head at rim, I get knee skin on rim. That's really good. Thank God you did it today in history. Thanks, Sky Lord. Energy, just someone yelling energy. And hi, Finn Bachelor says hi. Hi, Finn. Anyway, stay tuned for the Colombian edition Dunk Life Dailies. And please check out my vlog as soon as you finish this podcast. Blow it up for your boy. Let's go. Oh-hoo!
That's Dunk Life. Oh, that's the anthem right there. Tried to make an intro, ended up making an anthem. Oh!